Hello, I'm going to be talking to you today about some tips for writing your resume. So I have you viewing this webpage. You can access it yourself if you want to be able to look at it closer. It's mass.edu/gearup/documents/writingyourresume.pdf. I didn't make this document, but I found that this is a pretty helpful resource for students. So I'm going to review this with you. So you'll see starting at the top, the name, an address, contact information. This should be at the top of your resume. It should be your full government name, legal name, address, phone number, and email. You should include an email. I know this says if you have it. This was written a little while ago. You should have an email and it should be an appropriate one. And if you don't have an appropriate one, make a new email address. A lot of people will reach back by email. Separate it out, make sure it's bold, make sure it's clear, easy to read, no crazy fonts, no crazy colors, just pretty basic and standard. So then you're going to have your education. So you'll have Cocoa Beach Junior Senior High School, class of 2021, hopefully. So you will want to include your year of graduation and also your GPA. It's recommended that you're only including that if it's a 3.0 or higher. However, they may ask if even if it's not on there. So good idea to have that. Next, you'll see experience. So you'll see for this experience, it says St. Paul Public Library, University Branch, June 2005 to present. So the experience is the heading. You'll notice we have all our headings over here on the left. If you have an actual job or you've worked, you will have a whole heading for your work. This is more like volunteer experience that this is describing. So if you have both, you can use both headings. You can differentiate between volunteer and work experience. So your heading line, following your heading line, there should be a bulleted list. And you can see this example, maintained library, coordinated volunteer program, etc. Regardless of style, you should begin each bullet with an active verb, and I'll talk more about that later on. But this is important that everything's kind of standard. You can see that each category follows the same exact format, and that's pretty important, especially when you're writing your dates. So you'll see the library, it gives the year to present. Okay, so we're following that same formatting. So we're moving down to activities now. So these are things you were a part of in high school. And I like this example because you are high school students and this gives us activities category. In my resume as a professional, I don't have my high school activities on mine, but with that being what your primary experience is, this is what you're going to be using now. So National Honor Society, French Club, Cross Country, Piano Lessons. So you'll notice these are all bulleted and they give the dates. Very straightforward. So it talks here on the right about headings. If you're interested in reading that, again, I gave you guys the link. So hopefully that makes sense to you. And then other general formatting, you should have 1-inch margins, major headings on the left. Usually bolded and indent with the information below. Most information is going to be under bulleted lists, okay? It should all fit on one page. It's got to be easy to read, keep it simple and organized. Sometimes you might think that you've done so much, how could it possibly fit on one page? I graduated from high school almost 10 years ago and mine still fits on one page. I've had many different jobs. I've lived in 3 states and 3 countries. So you can definitely fit yours on one page. I know we all love to brag about ourselves and this is definitely an opportunity to make sure that they understand the big picture of who you are, but they don't need your whole life story. So keep that in mind. I wouldn't put middle school on there unless you have specific achievements from middle school, specific clubs or activities that you are a part of, but you don't need to put your middle school education. So earlier I talked about different action verbs So when you're describing your experiences, you're going to be using these action verbs to start your sentences. So you'll see under public library, maintained is the action verb. Okay, so when you're describing what you did, you are using these specific target action words. And it really depends on what you were doing. But here are some examples, and they're categorized really nicely for you so that you can kind of sort through those based on what you're doing or what you've done and writing your resume. So communication skills, technical skills, teaching skills, these are kind of transferable skills. Hopefully you guys remember that term, transferable. Those are skills that you can use amongst many different jobs. So those are skills you've started to learn in high school and you will continue to build. Technical skills or specific skills might not necessarily be on here if you've done something very, very specific, you know how to work some certain type of machine or something like that. So I would say use this list. I don't want to go through it, but the main point of this is that your first word in that sentence describing your experience should be one of these action verbs. So you can use this list, you can use these words. Make sure that obviously you're writing your own experiences here. If you have any questions, you can feel free to email me. I'm willing to help you out. My name is Mrs. Frappier. So let me know. I'm also in Portable N. So you guys can come down here if you're needing some help. I'm here. I'm willing to help you guys out. I know that there's probably a lot of information coming at you this week with all the events that have been set up for you. And I hope that you take this time to do this and use these resources while they're available to you, your teachers, your counselors, everyone is here. And once you graduate, those options aren't always open. So make sure that you're taking advantage of that and knowing that we're here for you and we're all here to support you. And congratulations, you are almost done. Okay, keep working hard and wear your mask so that we make sure we get you guys a proper graduation and a proper send off. Thanks guys, have a good day.